That says Sirba. There is not such a letter in English. U. You could say Sirba if you want. And the minute you say this in Eastern Europe, they means right away, automatically means jig. It's the same as when they say hora, it's the beat which we just played with you. Now they have different kinds of hora. They say slow hora, mid hora, fast hora, then they have batuta. Batuta is the same thing as hora, except it's like 7-8 times faster. So that would be batuta. And then when they say sirba, it's this, that's the beat. Until we don't play the sirba. We have to do it. So yeah, we'll play a bit slower. I'm just gonna pass quickly before we side read with the right hand. The left hand will do a very syncopated way, like. So it's not straight. The second it's. I do it with three, but whatever fingers you find, it's good.
You're getting like that?
Yes. But if you got used to four, it's fine. The most important is to have the syncopated. So that's the pattern, that's the beat of this style. Then in the tune also you're gonna see, once in a while you're gonna see a TR, a drill, which... So where you see TR, you hold it for the value of the note.
Chromatic.
Yes. Then also you might see one S upside down, gruppetto. Gruppetto, this is five notes on one beat. So that would be in part C. You'd see part C, you'd see an S on top of an F, upside down.
Oh. And what does that mean?
That they call it gruppetto, and you're gonna have to play five notes on one beat. No worries, everything is happening so fast, you're not gonna notice even. So F. Usually we play chromatic, but you see, like parts like this one, I will tell you in advance on F. You could make also with the tone, it sounds nicer. So from F, where is that gruppetto? So all of this. sound like that. And the same thing with 2, 3, 2, 1, 2. Now depends whatever fingers you choose, but in general it's good that you to be comfortable because it's sometimes there is tunes where you have lots of ornamentation one after the other one, so it's not everywhere you could use your third finger. So. Which they use in lots of Balkan music. They use once you feel comfortable with that, you're gonna use in lots of styles. Plus, it's pleasant. Ripeto. Mordendo, you already we did with you in the previous tune. So when you have mordendo, let's say the second box of part B. firstly to us. Not, we're gonna go to part B. It's going very good. Sight reading is very good. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go to part B. Tiny bit faster. three, one, two, three. Huh?
One whole thing?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Concentrate on the left hand and I'm gonna play the melody. Thank you. eight.
Mm-hmm.
If you do any walk, like base walking, it's fine, it's good. In this style,
yeah,
no, it's good. If you like, it's good to add all of that. Just the only thing in these styles of music, compare always to, you know, to another styles, they have to be like a Japanese knife.
Ah.
Like really, it's because sometimes when we do walking bass, we take and the tune is gonna be maybe 6-7 times faster. So you could do that, but that sounds more like a Napoletana or more like a, how do you call the other one, the I forget the sound. Yeah, the tarantella, yeah. Which is fine, but it's... pass one more time. Whatever feels comfortable, two hands together, only one, it's fine. And feel comfortable to add a bit more. Play a bit of the bell. Just to have more. The second time it's
thank you. driving partway into the bar.
Yeah.
You wait?
Mm-hmm.
To change
it. It's just a G7 like that. It's just
right.
Just normal, yeah.
On
just
straight
to, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Sometimes if they have half like that, they must put an F minor in the same measure the way you they have to put an F minor then a G7.
Okay.
Sometimes it's understandable, but I guess because it's in the middle, it's
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that one particularly looks like it's right over the tube.
Mm-hmm.
Or something.
Yeah. So just straight to G7. Maybe for the second time when you play C part, you could play a bit with some harmonies. It's the same G7, but maybe you don't play G7 in bass, but you play B instead of. And when you have C7, you don't play C7, but you play B flat. Then when you go to F minor, you play A flat. So all this history repeats. This goes back 500 years ago. They use the same thing in fugues, in preludes, and the same thing we had them today in there. In folk music, because they sound nice. So. Sure, I send you one more just to have a bonus, and you're gonna have to be in touch with Alan. He's amazing with the sending to everyone. You know, I'm sure you have all the emails.